So before we get into it, I just want to give a quick shout out to Sergey, who showed this to me, and I'm really excited to show it to you guys today because I think having these kinds of features in Magento is awesome. Here we are in the media gallery of Magento. Today I'm going to be editing some images for my store and I'm going to be selling hats. I've got some nice images that I've uploaded of my hats. First one I'm going to do is show you the cropping tools. Click these little dots and then click edit image to open up the editor, and I'm going to give this a crop. So you've got lots of options in terms of crops here. You can even do a custom crop, change it to whatever you like, or you can come into your theme and actually pick a crop that's relevant to what you're creating this image for. So I'm going to be creating this for the product page today. So I know it needs to be 700 by 700 and I want to keep all of her in there as much as possible. And yeah, I'm happy with that, and I'm going to save as, because I'm going to rename this as product page one. There we go, I'll click save, and there it is. Now I've got these two images here, and as you can see, it's also resized it appropriately for the product page as well, which is another tool that we've got as part of the image editor. And so I'm going to open up the editor again, and because this image is quite big, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to resize this down to be 1500 pixels, and as you can see, this little lock here means that the height also scales down with it, but you can unlock it should you want to stretch or squash your image. You are more than welcome to do that, and as you can see, it's distorted it, but you're well within your powers to do that, and you can even click save, and then you've got this nice squashed image, which that might be a mistake that you've made. Now the image is squashed, you can quite easily come back here and restore it from backup, which will then bring back the original image. The next thing I'm going to show you is some filters. So this image here, I quite like it, but it doesn't quite have the depth or vibe that I want. So I'm going to come in and have a look at what filters we've got. So let's have a look. There's absolutely loads to choose from. And the one that's standing out to me most, I think I'm going to go with is Marrow. I quite like that brightness vibe, but I think it's just a little bit too much. I'm going to bring it down slightly, up the contrast. No, that looks rubbish. I don't know about you. But what is nice, that if you do make a mistake or you're not quite happy with something or you want it back, up here you've got undo and redo buttons. So I can just take this back to the contrast that I had originally, which was zero. And there you can see me going through the filters as well. And yeah, back to the original image. The other thing that I'd like to show you is annotations, which I think are really cool. And so this allows you to add texts and images and shapes and all sorts on top of your image. So let's say, for example, I want to add some text here that says black hat, and that's $15.99. There we go. Oh, but I also want that to be bold, italic, maybe just slightly lower. There we go. And then I'm also going to add an arrow pointing to the black hat so you know which one it is. It's right there. I can also add an image if I want to, so I can pick from one of my other pictures of these lovely hats. Put that in there, and then I want to add a border to that, nice and thick. There we go. Perfect. Maybe I don't want this image, or the arrow probably is a bit much. Let's remove them. Okay, I'm quite happy with that now, but I'm going to save as, because I also don't want just the annotated image. That will be used on a very specific landing page. So now I've got the annotated image and the original image there. As you can see, it's a really cool feature. There's absolutely loads of options. You can make images look really, really cool, really, really easily. You can change all sorts of stuff, add a little bit of warmth, even add a little blur. So yeah, I hope you enjoy playing with it as much as I do.